resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. We meet in the name of Jesus Christ, who died and was raised to the glory of God the Father. May his grace and his mercy be with you. We look not to the things that are seen, but to the things that are unseen. For the things that are seen are transient, but the things that are unseen are eternal. Today we come together to remember before God our brother Norman, to give thanks for his life, and to comfort one another in our grief. Father in heaven, we thank you because you made us in your own image and gave us gifts in body, mind and spirit. We thank you now for Norman and what he meant to each of us. As we honour his memory, make us more aware that you are the one from whom comes every perfect gift, including the gift of eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So let's stand to sing our opening hymn, All People That on Earth Do Dwell.
Thank you.
This is a tribute that's been written by Sue for Norman. Norman was born in Wembley, Middlesex. He remained in London during the war. His home was just outside the area that was evacuated. But because of the bombing, schools were amalgamated, and he was in a class of 60 when he went to school. Imagine that, a class of 60. And he told Sue that shortly after starting, he decided that he would like to move up a year to the next class, but was very disappointed. And the teacher said he couldn't. He went on anyway to be head boy, and later studied economics at University College London. Then for his national service, he was assigned to the Royal Army Ordnance Corps. Apparently, that was the fate of all economists then. Trained as an officer in Chester, was later based in Buckinghamshire, having just missed being sent to Suez. He did make many good friends in the army. And after national service, he started work at Perkins Diesel in Peterborough. And then one weekend, he was returning to London to visit his parents. He decided to go to one of the regular Saturday night dances at his old college, University College London. Guess who he met there? It was a happy meeting. Sue continues, we married 2 years later and lived in a village near Stanford, a few miles from Peterborough. He came to Wedmore in 1964, 3 weeks before Guy was born, and when Norman started working for Clarkson Street. And Norman remained there for the rest of his career. He was a man of principles and strong convictions, a lifelong interest in politics and a strong belief in social justice. Norman sat on various financial advisory panels. He was a founder member of the Society of Business Economists, now renamed the Society of Professional Economists, of which Guy is now a member. And here in Wedmore, he was president and honorary president of the local conservation society until he died. Together, we supported and enjoyed local activities. Norman loved the theatre, and we went regularly as long as we were able. He made no secret of the fact that he was very impractical, and he believed in leaving things to those more able. Initially, I thought that this was just a good excuse that we could all try. But when I put it to the test, I saw what he meant. Sue writes, I should like each of us to celebrate Norman's life with many happy memories. And thank you all for coming today. And also for the many cards sent to us with such wonderful tributes. We look forward to seeing those who have arranged to join us for refreshments afterwards at the Isle of Wedmore Golf Club. Thank you. So we have a Bible reading now from St. Paul's first letter to the Corinthians. If I speak in the tongues of mortals and of angels, but do not have love, I'm a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away all my possessions, and if I hand over my body so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious, or boastful, or arrogant, or rude. It does does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. As for prophecies, they will come to an end. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will come to an end. For we know only in part, and we prophesy only in part, but when the complete comes, the partial will come to an end. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became an adult, I put an end to childish ways. For now, we see in a mirror, dimly. But then we will see face to face. Now I know, only in part, but then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now, faith, hope, and love, these three abide, but the greatest of these is love. Thanks be to God. We're going to stand to sing again our next hymn, All Things Bright and Beautiful.
I like more.
only sorry that I never really knew him until those latter years of his life. I liked him for his kindness, his inquisitiveness, and that quiet intelligence, all of which somehow just seems to come through in that photo, doesn't it? And those qualities he never ever lost, even though those last years, even through those last years as dementia took its wicked hold. I know that those past years he's been a shadow of who he used to be, but that old grace would also be there, that gentle personality, the old shaft of humour would still come through. So like all others of you here, I'm very glad to have known him. Very sorry that he is no longer with us. And I was very privileged to be able to play that part at his funeral and hand him back to his loving Creator. And we all know, don't we, that those last months and weeks for Norman and his family were really difficult. And Sue, Justin, Guy, and your families, I do hope that you have been able to feel the prayers, the support of so many in the community, so many in the church family. I hope that you've had a chance just to look behind you and see how many are here to support you and remember Norman today. And today is very much partly about acknowledging that loss, acknowledging grief, acknowledging the loss in the present. It gives space to focus what the family, what Norman has gone through, to articulate that huge void that a long, full and fulfilled life leaves. Just to stand alongside those whose grief is keenest. And I wouldn't also want to let today go without acknowledging that selfless care and love given to Norman by Sue that put flesh on those words, in sickness and in health till death us depart. But it's also, of course, so important on this day, on this memorial service day, to look beyond those last months, to remember, to give thanks for all that made Norman special. Give thanks to that long career at Clark's, to those decades spent in this village, for the decades spent with Sue and the family that they raised together. Because saying thank you is so much of what we are here today to do, isn't it? That's why we've gathered. Thank you to Norman for enriching our lives, and thank you to God for giving him to us. So I'm sure that you will gain a great deal of solace from the many happy memories of Norman, of a good life well led. I pray too that you will gain comfort from the faith that for Norman this is not the end. Amid all his achievements, all the stories, perhaps the most important thing I can say about Norman is that he was a man of faith. And Norman brought that questioning nature to his faith, as he did to everything. But when I asked Sue about this, he was able to say with great confidence, he believed in Christ. And that's enough. And the Christ in whom we put our trust and faith is a Christ whom not even death could keep bound. Faith, hope, and love, these three abide, as St. Paul famously writes. The faith, the hope, the love we see embodied in Christ abide. They go on, they never come to an end. Because at the heart of the Christian faith, his resurrection, and the hope of God's kingdom in which there is no more mourning or crying. So today, as well as looking back in thanksgiving, we can look to the future as well. We can look to our own futures and pray that we can leave behind all that gets in the way of us living the lives that God wants us to live. And we can look to Norman's future, confident that we can indeed hand him back to his Creator in the hope that he rests in peace and will rise in glory. Amen. So now, kneeling or sitting, let us pray. Father in heaven, we give you thanks for your servant Norman. We praise you as we recollect his life and cherish his memory. We bless you that in bearing your image, he has brought light to our lives. For we have seen in his friendship reflections of your compassion. In his integrity, demonstrations of your goodness, in his faithfulness, glimpses of your eternal love. Grant to each of us, beloved and bereft, the grace to follow his good example, so that we with him may come to your everlasting kingdom, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who died and rose again, and opened the gate of glory, to whom be praise for all eternity. Amen. And to the words, Lord, in your mercy, please respond, hear our prayer. Let us pray with confidence to God our Father, who raised Christ his Son from the dead for the salvation. Grant, Lord, that your servant, Norman, may know the fullness of life which you have promised to those who love you. Lord, in your mercy, amen. Be close to those who mourn, to Sue, to Guy and Kathy, to Justin and Kirsten, Harry, Naomi, Daniel, Fabian, and Esme. Increase their faith in your undying love. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
May we be strengthened in our faith, live the rest of our lives in following your Son, and be ready when you shall call us to eternal life. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Show your mercy to the dying. Strengthen them with hope and fill them with the peace and joy of your presence. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
And so we keep silent for a time to make our own prayers to God. We remember Norman this day. Lord, we commend all those who have died to your unfailing love, that in them your will may be fulfilled. And we pray that we may share with them in your eternal kingdom, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And as our Saviour Christ has commanded and taught us, we are pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And we finish our prayers with a prayer of entrusting. Almighty God, as you bring us face to face with our mortality, we thank you for making each one of us in your own image, and giving us gifts in body, mind, and spirit. We thank you now as we honour the memory of Norman, whom you gave to us and have taken away. We entrust him to your mercy and pray that you will show us the path of life and the fullness of joy in your presence through all eternity. So if you're able, please do stand for our final hymn, Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven. Spirit be among you and all whom you love, and remain with you always.